good morning, my dear children of class 8. Today is Saturday and I'm here once again with a video on these many topics. Today is the 12th and we are doing on chapter number 2. This is the last class I'm taking on chapter number 2. These are basic concepts of economics. So basically what we learned in this chapter are the basic concepts. So we are just forming our base to prepare ourselves in order to learn this subject of economics. So these are the last few terms I have for you to learn. The first is 2.13. I'm not giving you the page number, but 2.13. Per capita income. What is per capita income? Per capita income is the average income of a normal resident of a country in a given financial year. That means in given 1 year, how much on an average does an individual of a resident earn? On an average, how much does an individual of a nation earn? That is called per capita income. So symbolically, per capita income is equal to national income. There is a total income of a country divided by the total population. What you get is called a per capita income. So what does per capita income indicate? Per capita income indicate the standard of living of the people of a country. It indicates how good are the people living in a country, how well are they doing. These are some of the indications, whether the people are rich or poor, whether they are below the poverty line or above it. These are, in simple words, whether they are poor or rich. This is what it indicates. So next topic now is 2.14, and this is saving. Saving is that part of total income not used in consumption expenditure. So we have our income and we have our expenses also. So if my income, say for example, is 10, 10, 10, 10, and from this is my income, okay? From this, if my consumption is only this 10, I have consumed only one part, only 1 10 I have consumed. So remaining 30 is my saving. Did you understand? So this is the consumption expenditure, not used on consumption expenditure. So this is a total income, and out of this total income, the amount not used on the consumption expenditure is the saving. So saving is a part of total income, not used on consumption expenditure. There are different types of savings: personal saving, business saving, and government savings. Personal saving refers to those savings which are done by an individual. You can do that, I can do that. So that is a personal saving. When a businessman does the saving, that is a business saving, and similarly the government also does the saving, that is called the government saving. Next is the investment. What is the investment? Investment is the act of using productive resources for the production of capital goods. Investment means you prepare the productive resources. Productive resources are those resources with the help of which you can produce further in the economy. Like I have invested my money and made one building, and the production will take place there, isn't it? I cannot say let's start production there out in open. I need to construct a building. So that will become a productive, that will become building will become a productive resource for me. And what did I do? All the money that I used. That is called investment. So investment is the act of using productive resources for the production of capital goods. So the components of investment are producers' fixed investments. Producer will have to use their money, and that will remain there for a long time. It is a long purpose, for a long time, not for a short duration. Next is investment in residential and non-residential structure also. Residential are for those purposes which is used for stay, for our own stay. And non-residential structure like offices, warehouse, stocks, godown, okay, and inventory investment. Inventory investment means some of the stocks we may produce, but instead of selling them, we may stock. That is inventory investment. We have invested, we have produced, but we have stocked it. Sometimes we may produce, but that is a semi-finished good that is not yet produced. So a total of all this is called inventory investment. And for this also, this is also a kind of investment. The next that is important for us to understand today is the concept of the wealth. So wealth is the stock of all those assets which are a source of income. All those assets, all those useful substances which are a source of income, which can bring income to us as the wealth. This can be individual wealth or personal wealth. My wealth, your private wealth is all individual or personal. And there is a national wealth. National wealth is a sum of all the people's wealth in the country. Your wealth is individual wealth. My wealth is my personal wealth. But when this will be add up all the wealth of all the individuals of a country in a given time period, then what we get is of all the national wealth. And the last one is reproducible assets and non-reproducible assets. Reproducible assets are those man-made assets which are maybe naturally occurring, but those have been made useful by converting its forms. So those are man-made assets are called reproducible assets, like this building, consumer good, producer good, one saw, one hammer, one nail. These all are reproducible assets because man have produced them. And non-reproducible assets refers to those assets on which the human being has no control over production. Human being cannot produce, like land, minerals, forest. These are non-reproducible assets which human being cannot produce. So these are some of the simple concepts, dear children, you need to learn. Don't take it a trouble, just have a concept, just have a short and correct concept, and that will do at this moment for you in class 8. In detail we shall learn when you come to class 9. So we have concluded this chapter, and in short, here on page number, in my book on page number 28 and 29, the details and the terminologies in short have been given to you once again. And after that there are some questions, short type and essay type. Please do complete. Please do not wait for me to do everything for you. I'm here to discuss, I'm here to explain, but at the end you need to work yourself. You find the answer, write the answer, and if you have difficulties, please do ring me, please do ask me. I will suggest you, I will guide you, and I will give you some points regarding how to answer them. But you need to make a habit of working yourself. So listen to this video for a couple of times, definitely you will understand. This is not so difficult a concept. So till then, we shall meet again, and till then, you take care of yourself. Thank you.